Anything else?
All right, well, we have just one item today, old business, talking about, the title is repurposing of City Hall. We've been talking quite a bit about this. Just bring everybody up to speed real quick. Record reflected, Corey is here. Hey, Corey. Okay, didn't mark your absence, so we give you. Bring up speed with where we've been. We've had at least one special meeting to talk about this project. We also had discussions at a couple other meetings. At the last meeting, I believe the CIC had asked Dave and whomever, and Ken, Rob, Kelly, to go and work up a couple different kind of bookend proposals, you know, really to help us start, you know, framing the discussion here. You know, one proposal, really we're talking about ownership models more so than delivery models, but what would it look like, generally speaking, if the city owned this project and acted as developer, and what if they didn't? Okay, and you know, there's various models in between, but those seem to be the two extremes and seem like it make a lot of sense to start there. So with that, I'll turn this over to you again, Ken, and you've got a PowerPoint presentation, I guess, addressing kind of those two models and starting a discussion.
Okay. And I'll just add while he does it, staff met twice with Ken and Andy to go over the numbers and do a dry run to make sure these numbers were very accurate. So Ken did a great job of putting everything all together.
So really, what my charge was from the city was to develop a performance for the City Hall and to compare the ownership and to create some just typical conditions of that, whether it's a joint venture or whether it's a straight ownership. When you start a project like this, you really have to come up with a host of assumptions in this, because you're looking at conditions that aren't specifically present today, but you're assuming that they're going to go forward for evaluation. So for this project, I assumed a 10,300 square foot footprint. I assumed that the project would be prevailing wage on that, because we're going to be using tax revenue or some sort of tax revenue. I figured that any structure that was going to be constructed was going to be to general, typical municipal standards. The finishes would be that it would be a steel construction facility as opposed to a wood construction facility, and that it would architecturally be designed to match the downtown area. Now, getting into the nuts and bolts of this, I had to make some assumptions based upon typical conditions as it relates to development, construction, and estimates. So I assumed that they would be typical low, and I have a range here, and I'll show a range in this, but for the modeling purposes, you could model this, and we could have 6,000 different models for this. So I just assumed a typical low, which I believe you should be able to hit, and generally about $125 for the shell cost in this area, a $90 10 improvement cost, which would give you a Class A finish for municipal structures. I put $50 in there for the 10 improvements of TI for the retail space, with the assumption that anything beyond that would be the tenant's responsibility. And that's a general agency standard for retail construction, particularly when you look at restaurant construction or some type of service construction.
Can I ask a question? That 125 shell cost, does that include like the parking field in there? Or is that just the building?
No, it's the whole thing. And it actually is going to be all in, with the exception of the other additional cost in there. And I built in it, there's an additional contingency into that. When I'll show you when it gets to the end, the square footage cost is going to include all of that, include the design fees, the engineering fees, and the contingency.
But typically would not include a property cost.
When you say the
cost of property.
The purchase of that is for a joint venture. There's no cost to the city for that. But I did include a component for that if it's a joint venture in the sale of that. the transfer, that I'll get to that because I make that comparison.
Okay.
So it would be realistic.
I didn't hear the first part of the answer. Did you say the parking lots would be included in that? Okay, gotcha.
Everything's included with the exception of the things that I call out here. I included about a $75,000 demo cost. That's probably hot. The grading utility cost, you see the stormwater cost on that, a specific line item for a streetscape cost, that, and again, that's a high number for that, but I think that you're probably going to require, you know, very nice finishes and additional finishes on, beyond that. 5% contingency on that and a 6% design fee for the facility.
Now we're cooking with gas. Here we are.